Hello guys, my name is Kiki and in this video I am going to show you how I designed, 3D printed and built and programmed this 3D CAD mouse. It's a so-called space mouse. So let's get started. So as you most probably know, I love 3D printing. I use my 3D printers for my repairs. If you saw my previous videos, I repaired quite a lot of stuff by 3D printing broken components with my 3D printers, and for sure to do so I have to use quite a lot of CAD. I usually use Fusion C60 because it's free and it's a quite powerful tool. And I always liked the official 3Dconnexion or 3Dconnexion CAD mouses, space mouses. I always wanted to buy one, but they are super expensive. They are in the range of 140-150 euro, even the cheapest ones. I never reached the trigger limit to buy one. And I just woke up a few days ago and I saw that why don't I build one? I try to build one. And this is when I started to design this 3D mouse. It's not a one-to-one comparison to the 3D space mouse yet, because at the moment it only works in two axes, so you can rotate things in horizontal or in vertical positions, but it's already a quite powerful tool and I plan to do some updates to have way more functions like this by adding an additional buttons to the top and so on and so on. So let me explain you how it works. As you can see, it has a base, this bigger circular base, and it has a top which I can tilt in each and every directions. So the original 3Dconnexion space mouse work similarly, but it's using some springs and some optical sensors in the top of the unit, which is sensing the angular motion and the sliding in each and every axis. And this is how it's calculating basically the movements. You cannot reproduce the exact same, because 3Dconnexion has several patents to this, so you cannot use optical sensors, 3 or 6 optical sensors the same way. So what I did, I used an MPU 6050 accelerometer and gyroscope sensor, which I built in here underneath this cap. I will show it later on to you. And as soon as you tilt basically this cap, this top part, then you are causing an angular motion basically. The software is detecting this and sending this to the computer. So let me take it apart and let me show you how it exactly works. So it just friction fitted the top and the bottom part. And as you can see, there is a cavity here at the top. There is a spring. Basically, this is nothing else like a 3D printer bed spring. It's a quite strong spring. It's always coming back to the vertical position, so this way I do not have to use anything else, it's just coming back. It's pretty cool, and basically I just friction fit the two together. There is an Arduino Pro Micro board here. Later on I will also show you the schematic. There is a USB cable, and at the top part behind this plate there is the MPU 6050 accelerometer and gyroscope, and you just slide it back together. And it's done. So let me show you at first the schematic. So this is the schematic, it's super simple. As I told, this is the Arduino Pro Micro microcontroller. You have to make sure to use a microcontroller which has a native USB port, because otherwise it will not be able to communicate with the PC. And here is the MPU6050 accelerometer and the gyroscope board. So there are only a few cables. You have to connect the power, 5 volt, ground, and then the SCL and then SDA lines, which are the communication, the I2C communication lines. And basically here in the left, you can see the USB connections, because I could not fit a USB connector inside the case, and I did not want it to put it on the side of the mouse, so I used a USB cable directly connected to the board, and it's connected such a way that the ground cable goes to one of the ground cables on the Arduino. The D plus and D minus wires are going to these and these resistors here. These are the native data USB connection points directly going to the microcontroller. And V bus is just the power, so you can just solder it, for example, to here, to this point, which is a fuse. And that's it. And then let me show you the CAD model. It consists of three bodies. There is the bottom part, as you can see here, there is the cavity for the spring. I did not model here the spring itself. And then there is the space for the microcontroller itself. It does not fit perfectly, so this is the reason why I had to use a USB cable directly soldered to the board and not a USB connector, because it would not fit perfectly, and I did not want it to put here to the side in this direction the connector itself. So I just wired it directly. And then there is the middle part, as you can see on the here, there is the cavity for the spring, so this is basically the other part, and this is just friction fitted together. It holds the spring and the cup, and there are three screw holes here, these three, which are screwed to the top, to this top body. As you can see, these three screws are holding these two parts together. And then there is the two hole for the MPU6050 gyroscope and accelerometer module, which is on the top side. Here there is a hole for the wires, so this is how you connect the MPU module to the microcontroller itself. And that's it. Let me show you also a section analysis. This is the cross section, so the bottom part, the spring fits here, friction fits here, and there is this middle part, the MPU module is sitting here somewhere, and here with three screws you screw together this middle part with the top part, and this is the top part, that's it. And then you can tilt it in each and every direction. I just 3D printed all three parts, put everything together, wired everything together, and basically that's it. So let me just show you how I shortly put it together. So this is the bottom part, the spring is just press fitted into it, and then there is the USB cable, it's just a standard USB cable. I cut off the connector, and I soldered all the cables from the USB here. I already covered it with the glue, because these small little resistors here are super fragile, and you can easily break off the connections or the side of the capacitor, so take special care. So cover it with super glue, and then there is no tension on them. And then the four wires which goes to the MPU650 module. This is it, it's a really tiny one. And then this is the middle part, like here. Basically you just mount with two screws here. At the end I only used one screw, because there is a small capacitor really close to it and the head of the screw would interfere with it, but it holds it really tightly. And then what you have to do is slide through the four cables through this hole. And just solder the according to the circuit diagram. Okay, that's it. So everything is soldered nicely. So now I will just at first screw this part back to the case. Okay, so now the three M3 screws are secured. And then I pull back the USB cable here and fit the Arduino. If you use slightly longer cable than me, then you will have an easier job. And then I just align up everything and then press on it. And the spring just jumps into position and that's it. It holds pretty well. So for sure it depends on the accuracy of this 3D printer. So I designed it for my 3D printer. So maybe you have to tweak a little bit your settings. And as you can see, it works perfectly fine. It's super simple. And then let me show you how it works actually. Being recognized, then I switch over to Fusion C60. Okay, so here it is. As you can see, tilting it left and right is rotating this way. And up and down, it's rotating this way. And that's it for the moment. You can also combine the two. Super simple. I will show you also the code. I made a dead zone into the program, and as you can see, if I just barely move it, the model itself is not moving at all. And this is because if you do not move it exactly into the right direction slightly, you are interfering into the other axis. And you still only rotate it into the right direction. And you do not mix the two, basically. This way it's easier. And you can still parallel use your mouse. For sure, for example, for zooming. It's also really important that here I use Tinkercad options. So if you go into your preferences, then this shows up, and here in the pen zoom orbit shortcuts you can set different settings. So I use on the Tinkercad settings that this only depends on how do you like to use it. I use it on Tinkercad, and this means basically that if I just use the mouse itself, then I have to press on the right mouse and then I can do the same movements what I can do now with the 3D mouse itself. So if I press on the right mouse and move left and right, then it's spinning in this direction. If I press on the right mouse and move it up and down, then it's spinning in this direction. And this is exactly what I can do now with the help of the 3D mouse. If you want to use different settings here, you can also use Fusion C60, Inventor, SolidWorks, and so on and so on. But this way you have to change slightly the Arduino code itself. So let me show you now the Arduino code. So this is the Arduino code. It's super, super simple, that's all. And basically what it does, it's reading the angle, the angular motion basically of the MPU 6050 accelerometer and gyroscope module, and then it's calculating an angle, and then based on the angle then it's creating K keyboard and mouse commands which are sent over by the Arduino micro itself via the USB port. So let me just first run through the code itself. It's using the MPU6050 Lite library. It works really well, it's super simple. And then you have to use the wire for the I2C communication and the mouse and the keyboard libraries. And this is what I told, that basically it's sending over the same commands like the mouse itself is sending via USB to the PC. Here I have some variables. And then in the setup, I initiate the I2C communication and then the MPU. I start basically the MPU module and also the mouse and the keyboard libraries. And then in the loop, it's just updating in every 50 milliseconds. The loop is running. It's reading X, Y, and Z axis. I do not use at the moment X, Y, and Z. And what I forgot previously, there is this calculate offset, which is the gyroscope and accelerometer calibration. So whatever it means, that when you turn on the mouse itself, or when you plug in the mouse, then you have to put it onto your table and do not touch it, because at first it's making an offset calibration on all the three axes, and this way it's leveling out everything, and everything will start from 0 degrees. So even if you're, because of your spring, for example, your top cover is on a slight angle, it does not matter, because this calibration offset is offsetting everything out, and everything will start from 0 degrees. And so when you plug it in, do not touch it for a few seconds, and then after a few seconds you can already start using it. And then here I have an if else, and whatever it does, basically if the Y angle is higher than 7 or smaller than minus 7 degrees, these are in degrees, and as I told, this is the dead zone. So basically, so between plus and minus 7 degrees, it does not do anything. But if you are over 7 or below minus 7 degrees, then it basically pressing the right mouse. So this is what I told, that this is basically sending over the same commands like a mouse and the keyboard would send over to the PC. So in Fusion 360, in this Tinkercad setting that I have, to do this vertical and horizontal rotation, I have to press and hold the right mouse. So this is what it's doing. And then afterwards, with the mouse dot move command, it's moving the mouse basically only in the Y direction. The first one is for the X axis, but here we are only changing the Y axis. So X is 0, and then Y is minus 1 times the angle. Here minus 1 is just inverting the mouse. So when I move the 3D mouse up, then I want to rotate the part in the same direction, and here I had to invert it because it was rotating in the other direction. So it's nothing else. And this, the third command, is just the scroll, but we do not want to scroll, so we only move in Y direction, and that's it. And then the else if is doing the exact same thing, but for the x-axis. So here the first parameter is changed by the x-ang variable, the y and the z, the y and the scrolling is not. And else, so else means in this case that if none of these are true, it means that the mouse is not touched, it's in the original position, then basically it's releasing the right mouse, and it's pressing ESC to exit from this. And that's all. So it's super simple. As I told, you could use it on Fusion 360 settings, on SolidWorks settings. You only have to change these variables here, the keyboard and the mouse commands, and you can check all these in the keyboard and mouse modifiers. For example, on the Arduino website, you can find, for example, the keyboard modifiers, and here you can see I use ESC button, so you have to send key underline ESC to the PC to press the ESC button. So it's then basically simulating like you are pressing the ESC button. So that's all. And this is the same for the mouse, all these mouse commands. It's mouse.press, so it means that you are pressing the right mouse. And in additional mouse.move, so you are moving in X direction by X angle value. And that's it. You can also play with the sensitivity by adding here a multiplier factor, for example, 1.5 times X angle means that it will move 50% faster, and so on and so on. So I'm pretty happy with this, to be honest. It works really well. I'm planning to do some updates on this. As I told, I will put an additional button here onto the top, but you can press on it, and then, for example, if you press it or tilt it forward and backwards, then, for example, it's zooming in and out. And if you move it left and right, then you can do something else. I did not saw this through yet, but yeah, there are basically a lot of additional possibilities to play with this. Okay guys, so I hope you found this video helpful. I hope you enjoyed this. If yes, please like the video, subscribe to my channel, and I hope I see you next time. Bye.